Hello, Aquarius. Welcome. Welcome to Window to the Soul. My name is Gemma, and today I'm going to be reading a relationship spread for you. I do have a couple of messages, so please do feel free to jump to the timestamp to get straight to the cards if you would prefer to skip that. Firstly, a little information as to how you can get the most out of these readings. Do have an open mind as to who your person is. For many of you, there will be no doubt you've come here for a specific person, and that is who will come through. If, however, someone else's energy is strongly with you right now, whether you're aware of it or not, that person may essentially hijack your reading. It's also worth noting that this might not necessarily be a romantic connection. This could be a friend, a family member, or a work colleague, for example. Do be aware, Aquarius, that you are so much more than just your sun sign. You should definitely be open to exploring readings for your rising, your moon, and your Venus sign at the very least. Often you will hear myself and other readers prompt you to take the reading as it resonates. You will know if any of the messages that come through here today are for you, because it will feel as though I am speaking directly to you. And if most of it resonates, but there are maybe, say, one or two things that just don't feel right, then don't force those parts to fit. Probably all it means is that those particular parts were for someone else. Crosswatchers, of course, you are most welcome here, and all the above applies. If you want a reading that is more geared towards your specific situation, I am taking bookings for private readings for March and April. Readings will be pre-recorded. They are a 30-minute minimum at a cost of $40 each. You will have the opportunity to tell me any relevant details about your situation and, of course, to ask your questions. You can email me on windowtothesoultarot@outlook.com for inquiries. And lastly, there is an extended reading for what we look at today over on Patreon. For $5, you will gain access to all of the extended readings for all of the signs, plus all bonus content. The link to that and everything else is in the description. Aquarius, let's get into some cards for you. This is intended to be you. Time for a nap. And this is intended to be your person. Serendipity. Okay, that's kind of nice. You're certainly sleeping on this connection right now. That much is clear. Do be aware that this could be flipped for some of you. I will proceed as though this is you, Aquarius, and this is your person. However, you take it as it resonates. Your person kind of waiting for a sign or a synchronicity, waiting for some kind of heads up from the universe, kind of waiting. It's almost like the energy of kind of sending it out into the universe and then just waiting for it to manifest. It is a card of hopes and dreams and wishes, but also a card of kind of release. It's true, law of attraction and manifestation here. You might be dealing with somebody quite spiritual, quite powerful here. You are sleeping on this connection right now. Why? What's up with that? What's going on? Ooh, you have the mountain, which always presents as quite a formidable challenge with the promise of some hard work, obstacles to overcome. That's interesting energy. Your person certainly feels a lot lighter, it has to be said. What's going on with this? Goodness me. I mean, we have two cards of four-leafed clovers. Your person kind of feeling lucky, wanting to take a chance. Your person feels good. You feel heavy and lethargic. Like you know you need to kind of go ahead and take on a challenge here and do something, but ugh, just the thought of... It's like the first step is the hardest, you know? It just feels like such a challenge. You're not even sure where to start, honestly. Whereas your person here, very, very feeling lucky, taking a chance, possibly hoping for some kind of changes or waiting for, as I said, some kind of sign from the universe before any action is taken or fascinating energy. Okay, let's see what goes down the center line here, and we'll start painting a picture for you here, Aquarius. I'm going to get the past, present, and future energy of this connection that is mutual because this will be down the center line here for both of you, and we'll see where the energy is going. Right now, I don't see either of you coming towards each other. Past energy of this connection is the Four of Cups, which is absolutely rejection. Perhaps somebody was kind of wrapped up in themselves. Perhaps somebody wasn't, you know, this, you feel here a little bit kind of wrapped up in yourself, focused on yourself here, don't really have the time or the energy. This person is, it's a little blasé, honestly, a little bit kind of not indifferent, just whatever, dude, you know? So there's perceived rejection on both sides there, isn't there? But I'm not sure if that was really intended as a rejection by either of you. You know, you may have very, very good reasons to be kind of wrapped up in yourself and the things that you're dealing with in your life right now. Present energy is one of your cards. The Moon in Aquarius, the Seven of Swords. It's deceptive behavior. It feels like there's some self-deception here going on. However, somebody's definitely left this connection, whether it be romantic, friendship, whatever. Somebody has energetically pulled themselves away. I think it's possibly you. And this person either genuinely doesn't care, or is certainly acting as though they don't care, or it could be actually that they're not taking it personally. They understand why. And they're okay and getting on with their own life in the meantime. Like, okay, if Aquarius needs some space or some time or whatever, then I respect that. That's cool. That's okay. But somebody definitely left, energetically at least. Future energy of this connection. Oh, that's so lovely. The Six of Cups. Memories, nostalgia. Now again, we have this kind of dwelling on the past thing going on, though. This could be a soulmate. This genuinely could be a soulmate here. There could be a reconnection in the future. And it looks like a nice reconnection, honestly. The energy here feels light. It feels nice. For this connection, I think whatever's going on for you here, Aquarius, I think you've pulled away from this person. I actually don't think it's personal, and I don't think this person's taking it personally. There's no animosity here. We just seem to avoid. This is like a friend that you kind of just lost contact with, and there wasn't. There was no good reason for it, really. Like almost drifted apart. And I think it was instigated by you, honestly, or if you have identified that this side is your person, you know, then flip the reading around in that way. But this person seems okay with it. They understand. They're cool, okay? Right. Heart space, head space, action towards. So heart space is essentially, of course, how do you feel about each other? Head space is what are your thoughts about each other? And action towards is your intended action, physical action in the 3D world towards each other. Head space for you is the Princess of Wands, which is the Page of Wands. It's kind of hopeful. It's nice. It's hopeful. Your person's heart space, Six of Swords. Yeah, they've pulled away. That's another one of your cards as well. They're kind of cool. They've detached too. I think they have kind of followed your lead there. You've detached, and so they've just moved into a space of radical acceptance regarding that. And okay, your call. I think they would have been here had you had remained invested. But your lack of investment, it's not something that they're kind of dwelling on or devastated about or angry about. It's just like they have people in their life that are invested in them, and so they're focusing on them. It's kind of like no hard feelings. How your headspace is the Three of Swords. Yeah, that sucks. That hurts. Their headspace. King of Swords. Okay. This person feels very, very. I don't want to say detached or indifferent. It's just accepting. I don't feel they were kind of given much choice. I think you're dealing with some stuff. I actually think you're dealing with some stuff here. And I'm getting this vibration here, Aquarius, that this was potentially a good friend, possibly a good friend that may have slightly tipped into a little bit flirty, a little bit potential. The seed was there, right? But it never kind of went that way. And I think you pulled away because your feelings were deeper than you wanted them to be. Okay, and do remember, I am being reminded again that this might be flipped. Okay. I think I will proceed as this is you, but I do feel that I'm moving into a stage now where for many this is flipped. This person kind of liked this person. I don't know if this person felt the same, if there were romantic overtures or not. I think there was a deep connection, a really deep connection. I think you absolutely bonded with this person, like loads in common, really enjoyed each other's company. Who's to say whether this could have gone somewhere or not? But this person, for some reason, decided it could not be, and I think was afraid of their own feelings and kind of stopped this from proceeding before they got too emotionally invested. So your action towards this person is the Four of Pentacles. That's still holding on to this. Yeah, I don't think you'll be taking any action. Their action towards you is the Fool. They are ready to kickstart this connection again, should you want it. They're kind of easy either way. I don't think this person is as emotionally invested, but I do think this person thoroughly, thoroughly enjoys you. This person has two cards of Aquarius, the Fool and the Six of Swords here. This person enjoys you. This person enjoys you a lot, enjoys your company, has the time for you, would be willing to engage with you 100% here. They're not taking this personally, but I do think they are entirely unaware that there may have been some emotions that were getting a little bit deep here for you. Again, do know that this might be flipped, so I might be saying you and this might be your person. I actually feel I've got a few cross-watchers here today as well. Hello, cross-watchers. Let me know if you're cross-watching in the comments section. Yeah, you have a position. You have a card of the heart in the head space, which means you are considering, you have been in terms of this connection, considering matters of an emotional and heart-centered nature with rational logic. Okay, so that logically you have looked at these feelings that you have been developing for this person and thought, yep, nope, that can't happen. I am falling for this person. I possibly like this person too much. That cannot be. So it's easier for me to not engage. I think your heart really, really digs this person. I think you really enjoy this person. I think you really like this person. I think the feeling is absolutely mutual here. In their head, it's kind of like, well, Aquarius obviously isn't bothered, so I'll focus on the people that are bothered. Okay, all good, all good. Not really sure what happened there, but maybe Aquarius has got other people or other thing. I don't know. Kind of feeling like a very spiritual vibe from this person. Perhaps, Aquarius, I'm gonna say the thing. I'm gonna say the thing. People perceive Aquarius as cold and detached. You are a super duper independent sign. I'm a Gemini. I'm also value my freedom and my independence. All the air signs do. We need to breathe. We need space. But Aquarians get a little bit of a bad rap for being detached and cold. It's absolutely not true. It's a misconception of the energy that Aquarius give off. When Aquarians fall and when they connect with somebody and fall in love, they feel love. They feel it deeply, deeply. It resonates in their soul, but they also need space to breathe. I think what I'm getting at here is I think this person understands what Aquarius is like. I think they know you, they get you, and they know that you need freedom and that you need space. And I don't think they take any of this personally. I think they just recognize that. I don't think they think that you were as invested as you were. I think they feel that this. Okay, so maybe Aquarius was a bit more casual than I thought. Okay. Kind of sucks, but all good. All good. I think this person would be absolutely ready and willing to engage with you again. But I don't actually think. I don't know. Have they tried a few times and been knocked back? Yeah, possibly. And again, I still don't see them taking it personally. I don't see any animosity or anger or bitterness or resentment. I just see them, and I think we've kind of done this with you before, haven't we, Aquarius? It's like they've kind of taken the hint, right? And gone, okay, Aquarius isn't bothered then. That's a shame. And just moved on. You do with that whatever you feel should be done. If this is you, and you've identified this is kind of where you're at, or you're a crosswatcher and this is your Aquarius, perhaps this is a little bit of a revelation. This person kind of cares a lot. This person was in danger, and that's the way they viewed this, in danger of falling in love. They knew it, they saw it, they felt it. I'm not sure this person had any idea. But I don't think this connection has actually been explored enough for this person to even dare to find out. You do have the Six of Cups, which is a deeply felt mutual connection. It's a card of soulmates. And soulmates are not necessarily romantic in nature. Could be that if we can kind of move past this complicated romantic energy, there is a really good friend sat here for you, Aquarius. Maybe they do feel in a similar way, but I think the reason why it's not coming out that way is because we never even got to that point. I think the moment you recognized you were catching feelings, you backed off. You backed off immediately. You may have had very good reasons to do that. Perhaps this person is already partnered or unavailable in some other way. And you just didn't want to complicate things or mess things up. Perhaps you tried to be friends and recognized that was too hard. That was too hard. I will take this over to the extended. I'm going to get some more cards on all of this. See if we can dig into this a little bit deeper. So this, if this was one that really resonated for you, you might want to hop on over to the extended over on Patreon. Good luck with this one, guys. I will be back very soon. I am aware I still have to do your yearly spread. It is coming. Thank you so much for your patience with that. I will be back, of course, for the February readings for each of the signs as well. So do keep your eye out for that if you are subscribed to the channel. Thank you for everybody's support, kind comments, kind words. Love you guys very much. Do take care.